welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much to all of you who have liked, shared, commented, subscribed. Those of you who have been sharing, well done. Thank you so much once again. And if you are new here, my name is Mwaka Mugala, and on my channel I talk about all things beauty, health, lifestyle, and just allow you into my world. So if you don't follow me already, just do so on my social media platforms as well. That's Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and TikTok. And please subscribe as well. Hit the notification bell so that every time a video comes out, you are the first to know. Now, speaking of letting you into my world, I'm going to tell you a story today. And it's a very interesting story, I hope. But it's one of those things I don't really like to talk about. But today, I think I'm ready. Now, before I get into that, a lot of you have been asking how to get over a heartbreak, especially with teenagers. It's hard, but it's inevitable. So I do have a video on that, how to get over a heartbreak. I will link it in the description box and you can check out that video after this one. So in today's video, I am going to tell you a story about the time I got cheated on. Come closer. Closer. Don't be scared. Come. I've never been cheated on. Yeah, if only that were true.
This is me, whether you like it or not. Quick to talk, but you do not do a lot. If I change, then it will be for the better. No apologies, so don't expect.
Alright guys, so let's get right into it. It's a bit of a lengthy story, so if you're going to have a snack, you know, a cup of tea, do take some tea, you know, get comfortable. It's hectic. Let's go back to 2009. My gap year, I'm waiting for my results to come out so that I go into uni. I decided to join the small Christian community at church. And I was in the choir, you know, I was very active at the time. And I was the secretary for the small Christian community in which I was. And this guy, let's just call him Guy, okay? He was the vice chair. So because of that, we were working very closely together because we had a whole year of activities lined up, you know, charity work, youth picnics, get-togethers and everything. And we always had Bible study every two weeks. So on the Sunday, so because of that, you know, he started to show interest, and for me, I wasn't interested. I was just like, look, my main focus is school. Right now I just want to focus on myself. I'm not interested in guys, you know, my parents say boys, so I was like, okay, not interested. But he was very, very persistent. So because of that, eventually he did get under my skin, and I was like, okay, yeah, sure, let's give it a shot. And it happened when we had a youth picnic at Adventure City. It was very nice, very well organized. We cooked, we organized the drinks and everything. The parents had to be there, of course, because they sponsored. But also, I think they just wanted to supervise us, because you know when we get excited at such things. So after that, when the event was done, we went over to his parents' place where they were staying, because my parents were supposed to pick us up from there and then take us home. We get there, parents arrive, there's two. Socializing, so we were chatting, and then eventually I was, you know, smitten, I guess. And so we decided to give it a shot. And then fast forward to November, we both got accepted to UNAM, but I wasn't given accommodation. So my parents were like, look, because you don't have accommodation, it might be a bit expensive, first of all. Secondly, if anything happens to you health-wise, we won't even be able to take care of you because you've been so far. How about we just wait for you to go to UNSA? And I'm like, well, what if I don't get accepted to UNSA? Because at this point, it's a huge gamble. And I'm like, well, you can always try again next year. I'm like, next year, I can't be at home for another year, first of all. Secondly, my friends will be in school, you know. It was a lot. So I really, really wanted to get into UNSA. Meanwhile, he had gone to UNAM and we had continued communicating, you know, chatting on the phone, butterflies and everything. Then, January, results come out, I'm accepted, I'm excited, me and my friends did the processes and everything, and everything was going well. School started, the pressure was real. February, him and his cousin and I, rather, we're quite quite close as well, quite close friends. And so he decided to break the news down to me one day. You know, I couldn't believe it because it just happened so fast. It was like, hey, hope you're well. Listen, I don't want to be this person, but I think you're a nice person and I think you deserve to know what's going on. He says, well, guy has been seeing someone from this class. I swear, like, I could literally just hear everything go quiet. And I started getting confused. I'm like, what do you mean? Because I couldn't believe it. I'm like, this is like kind of my first-ish relationship. You know, it's one of those where I was even like, you know, we're going to get married. So I'm going to wait till I get married. And we're going to be the perfect family. Our parents get along. We're both Catholic. His surname starts with M. So I'll still be MM. Yeah. All of that went through my mind. So he told me the name of the girl. And I was just like, oh, okay. So I texted him immediately. I'm like, I've been told this is the situation. Is it true? Guy didn't even bother lying. You know, some people are like, no, it's not true. He just immediately said, yes, it's true. This is her name. We do economics together. And sometimes I study from a place. We do assignments together. And it's too late for me to go back into school. So I end up staying in her room. And I'm just like, okay, cool. So I remember that night I texted a friend and she was, we're in the same boarding house. So I went to her room and she's like, Mary, you can stay here. It's fine. You don't have to be alone because my roommates had gone home for the weekend. I stayed in her room, but I didn't sleep the whole night. I was just thinking and like, what is it? So I even stopped her on Facebook. Not proud to admit that, but I stalked her and I saw like all the comments she would leave under his post. I looked at her picture and I sort of gauged a bit of her character because she was very vocal. So I started thinking to myself, like, is it because I'm too quiet? Is it because I'm too churchy? Is it because I don't drink? Is it because, like, I just thought of all sorts of things? Is it because I don't cuss? Like, am I too boring? So those are the questions I started asking myself and I'm like, how? You know, it's confusing because you start to think like, am I just not good enough? But it happened and I was quite devastated. You know, the next day my friends all showed up and they were like, look, let's just have fun. There was a swimming pool at the boarding house, so we were swimming. We were just like, yeah, let's have fun, let's do this thing. And they tried to talk to me and be like, look, it's not the end of the world, the usual, there's many fish in the sea, blah 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 blah. And I was like, it was hard to believe, but at the same time, as much as that was a very devastating situation for me, I actually learned a lot from it. And that's kind of how I was able to even come up with some of the points that you will hear in my heartbreak video. The link is in the description box below. Please check that out. So yeah, I really don't like telling this story, but well, I didn't like telling the story, but I've healed now. I'm okay. We don't really talk anymore. No, we don't talk at all. Once in a while we pop up. Oh my gosh. Okay. I'm going to get into another story. So this one time he just randomly popped up and he was like, hi, how are you? Are you okay? Now this was a period where something had happened on social media and I was accused of something, and so it was a bit of a difficult time for me. So when he called, in my head I'm thinking, like, is he calling to like gloat or to laugh at me? And I texted my best friend about it and she's like, just ignore him. So then coincidentally, when I went to my Facebook memories, I checked the date and it was actually our anniversary date. And I was just like, oh my gosh, this is what, 10 years later and you're texting me on our anniversary date to check on me? So yeah, that was the time I got cheated on. For me, first year university experiencing such things, I was destroyed, I was hurt, but I managed to heal and to move on and to learn how to deal with such situations. So if you'd like to share as well your heartbreak story, do so in the comment section below. And if you'd like to hear more stories like this, because I am planning to just have a little session where I tell you stories and chat a little bit, let me know once again in the comment section below what else you would like to hear from me. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. Once again, please don't forget to subscribe, share with your friends. Someone out there might be helped by this story. And till next time, do take care. Love you guys. This is me, whether you like it or not. Quick to talk.
but you do not do a lot. If I change, then it will be for the better. No apologies, so don't expect a letter. Sit down and listen, hey. If you do not like